Hello guys and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to discover how to run Hero Wars on your PC. As you can see now, you are displaying it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and install Hero Wars and enjoy playing this game on our Windows computer with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun, let's go buddies. First of all mates, to get started we have to launch our favorite browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to the next URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, simply because I added the clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We landed on this page on our own website of Usitility, exactly where we get a meticulous outline on the best way to download and install Hero Wars on laptop or computer. We scroll down a bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we reach the website of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to get access to this game Hero Wars on our PC. As you can discover from here, we get a great deal of pros of using the emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Now we are on the way to proceed to download the Hero Wars by clicking on the button Download Hero Wars on PC that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on the button, and the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the installer. Okay, then we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the computer. We have clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installer much better. The installer is straightforward. It includes two possibilities: install and setup path. I will show you what setup path actually does. We basically just simply click on it. So we discover that they got here the path where your emulator will be set up. If we have to vary this folder, we are required to click on this browse option. Therefore we pick another folder and set up the emulator precisely where we choose. I am going to leave it by default. Then, I click on back. So I just click on install. Right now, before beginning the installation of the emulator, it is also possible that it'll offer us one or two application packages to add on the computer. Because I do not want any of these software, I purely press several times on the reject option. Voila, the install commences and it will continue together with the download of all these MB which are visible on this computer screen. As you save it on your computer, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The download speed can be at a higher speed or slower, determined by your web access and according to the efficiency of the emulator web servers. Today they're running super fast. The download is finished, and so at this time it proceeds with the setup part. The setup needs a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your computer or laptop. The more robust it's actually, the shorter the installation time and vice versa. If we integrate the download and install phase, it will take quite a while, so have patience. It is by now ended for me. At this moment, the emulator has actually been launched instantly. As you can observe, down here, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right, then when it gets into the finish, the emulator can be started for the very first time. The fact is the emulator was already launched, here it is for the very first time. Plus LD Store is immediately launched, which is a sort of Google Play. It isn't really the smartest option to set up the video game, and I also tend not to endorse it, for the reason that typically the LD Store puts an outdated version of the game. I will explain the way to install the video game making use of the Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we will have to begin doing is to navigate to the desktop by hitting this software icon that I'm indicating in green color. Before we carry on, as you can observe, it made two app icons right here on the computer desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer app icon will be only one we're concerned about. Anytime we desire to launch Hero Wars on the laptop or computer, we double-click on this app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything at all such as that. Basically, it's an software icon that we might very likely never ever work with. Why don't we perform the next step, that is a must-have, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. To do that we will browse here to System Apps, we click. And we will simply click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is presented. In this case we need to sign in. At this time as soon as we are there, we must absolutely begin doing this next phase that is absolutely mandatory. So that we just click on, sign in. At this moment it announces, checking info. It may from time to time get stuck in, checking info, that's why it isn't going to advance. If that's the case, you could try to log in after a number of hours but it will surely most probably be corrected. At this moment we shall type our login name and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. As an example, you make use of the very same email you're using at the moment in your own YouTube account. Thus, I will submit my data and I will come back after I have done it. That's it, details inserted. This is Google welcoming us and supplying us their twos. We must say yes to them all by simply pressing, I agree. Following, it allow us to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it selected and this will generate a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can make use of that option if you prefer. We click accept. The Google Play is presented by default and automatically. In the event that the Google Play just isn't started by default and you are unsure how to start it yourself, I teach you how to do so. First thing is to proceed to the emulator desktop by pressing this app icon noted in green. At present we navigate to the system apps folder. And we click on the Play Store icon. Alright, I am there within Google Play. What we will perform will be browse here to, search for apps and games. And we're going to look for Hero Wars. So there we end up with it, we must select the very first result. There we access to the video game. Why don't we then click there on the install link that I'm just presenting now in green color. And this will initiate the setup. At present it should download and install the Android game. It typically takes a bit of time or perhaps it might well be amazingly quickly. That all is dependent upon on our own internet connection. It has already ended setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking the following button that I am presenting in green, if you want to start Hero Wars for the first time. We're at present on the emulator desktop, then we're about to just click this fresh Hero Wars app icon that was provided. This video game is launched for the first time. Here we get it. I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the sound level of the emulator. It is here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the max, we could turn on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is simply the very first one. We mouse click on this icon which I'm designating in green color. And the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. Assuming that we aspire to run the video game in full screen, we hit that game icon. And we might without a doubt be enjoying the video game in full screen function. To get out of the 100% screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And we might currently be in normal computer screen setting. At present, I am ready to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping which is actually surprisingly exciting. That step we definitely will be in a position to play the game app far more effortlessly. The very first task is to click on this keyboard icon. It's now time to make the required setups. Let me let the normal settings, though if you require to adjust this, you can easily do so with no problem. I consider this moment to comment that from time to time, when beginning the game application a dark screen occurs, if it's so and you get the black display and this emulator fails to initiate, I suggest a possible solution. We would browse here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator options, in the advanced option we get quite a lot of graphic resolutions. That is the image resolution we have previously opted for automatically and so we must choose any of these additional resolutions, for instance that one listed below. We choose it and consequently click on save. It will probably require us to reboot your emulator and immediately after reboot it, probably the emulator will launch and that black display will be completely removed. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our language. From time to time it happens that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, for instance, in Japanese. And therefore to set it up in the correct language we go here to the cogwheel. Then right here throughout additional configurations, we simply click on the language drop down. We are able to select the language we wish. German, Mandarin, and so forth. After the language is decided, we are going to save, the emulator will reboot, and the game, the next time we start it, would as well be in the preferred language. At present, there's another aspect that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will get a message from Google telling you that a different equipment has been associated with our own Google account. It is going to question us if we are the ones who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we ought not be troubled, since the emulator is acting as an Google Android smartphone or tablet. In order to identify which electronic device is being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Therefore we go here to the model option. And right here we learn that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for this training. I hope that you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was interesting. If that is so, allow it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and any comments, questions or ideas, leave them in the comment field below. You also can leave comments on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams every now and then. You get it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Check out any of these online videos that are appearing on the screen and see you in the next video game videos. Bye.